start one global digital currency to stop the world economic collapse. Dear viewers, please invest 20 minutes of your valuable time for the sake of all 8 billion people on our planet. Today is 3rd September 2020. 1. The background. For thousands of years, gold was a global reserve currency. But mining gold not only damages the environment, but transporting and storing it also is a headache, and hoarding it did not give any interest income for a long time. After the Second World War, the USA became a superpower, and since it had 75% of the world's monetary gold and had pegged $35 to 1 ounce of gold, countries naturally started trading mostly in US dollars, making it de facto reserve currency of the world. Investment in US bonds also gave decent return for many years, but this financial new world order started falling apart from August 1971 when the US President Richard Nixon severed the direct convertibility of US dollars into gold. 2. The problem. Governments world over print fiat currencies, that is, without having any intrinsic value backed by gold, leading to a situation where many of these currencies become worthless, causing hyperinflation and enormous sufferings. We have seen this happen in 56 countries, including Zimbabwe, Greece, Venezuela, China, Hungary, Argentina, Peru, Yugoslavia, Germany, France, Nicaragua, etc. The world cannot take any further refuge in the US dollars because the American government is printing dollars like never before. Coronavirus pandemic will be the needle that will soon prick this unsustainable bubble, and we are about to witness times worse than the Great Depression of 1929. The world has got addicted to the US dollar, and the Americans are more than happy to keep supplying endless amounts of it to keep getting goods for doing nothing. It takes just a few cents to print a US $100 bill, and they will want to keep the party going on forever, and the world will keep sinking deeper and deeper into the US dollar black hole. Even if the Americans do not work, they can keep living the life of kings, whereas the entire world becomes paupers, were working harder and harder, subsidizing the rich American lifestyles. China is planning to back yuan with gold, but why should the world not trust China, having suffered by making US the spoiled brat? Bitcoin is another fiat currency, which no government will ever allow to become legal, as they cannot get taxes from it, neither do they have the right to issue it. Going back to gold is like going back 5,000 years, in which a country which has more gold becomes more powerful. Gold and silver is just a rare piece of shiny metal in which any money pumped is money sucked out from the financial markets, leading to no value creation. Euro was a good idea, but issued physically and narrow in its geographic appeal, with complicated and difficult criteria for European countries to opt for it. Short-term stimulus is like applying a bomb when one is suffering from cancer. What is required is chemotherapy and surgery. When a building becomes old and rickety, you cannot keep propping it with bamboos for long. It will fall, crushing all residents staying in it. When a hard disk gets corrupted, we have to format it. When the technology used to create a program becomes obsolete, patchwork will not help it for long. You need to build a new code from scratch using the latest technologies. It is time to bail the cat. The huge crisis we are faced with right now deserves a complete overhaul, a complete out-of-the-box idea to avoid the impending death spiral. All countries are fighting currencies war and bleeding to death in this red ocean. The system is completely broken. So what is the way out from this cascading freefall? Should we just wait for the situation to get completely out of control and stare at a decade of global meltdown? Well, after thinking for many years, I have come out with a simple solution which is very easy to understand and implement. 3. The solution. Whenever a company wants a loan, the bank interested in giving it checks its credit ratings and carefully verifies the last 2-3 years audited balance sheets, profit and loss, debt equity ratios, etc., and then decides what maximum amount of loan can be given to that company. Otherwise, they will take the bank down with it. A country is similar to a company and must run it responsibly, keeping its debt and expenses in control. Banks and rating agencies can audit its GDP figures for the last 2-5 years. So all the countries of the world must come together with one single equal vote for each country to form a single global digital currency bank called a GDC bank and float a single universal digital currency called GDC. Only the GDC bank will have the right to decide how much GDCs can be created, how much of it to be given to each country, and maintain all countries' digital ledgers transparently online for all other countries to see. Each country's central bank can then decide how much of their GDCs to be transferred into each citizen's bank account. The GDCs will be created simultaneously together by all the countries through one rep from each country doing these activities impartially online, just like the non-profit body ICANN maintains the internet systems running smoothly globally. No country, big or small, will suffer any loss. Countries with higher GDPs will get more GDCs. Each and every country will get the same percentage of GDC as its verified GDP total is for the last 2 to 5 years. The actual number of years will be decided by the GDC bank, such that there is no GDC shortage for day-to-day transactions. Every year, if the country's GDP increases, the GDC bank will verify it and accordingly add the GDC amount. But if the GDC goes negative, then no additional GDC will be given to that country. No country will be allowed to create any GDCs. One GDC value should be very less. Maybe 5 GDCs could be valued at 1 yen, so that the poorest of the poor can buy the cheapest of things in their countries without any difficulty. In case initially it is decided by the GDC bank that 3 years GDP total will be taken as the GDC total to be given to each country, and later on that figure is found to be insufficient and 5 years GDP total has to be taken, it will have to take earlier year GDP figures rather than of the future, as the past figures cannot be manipulated. No country can be refused to become a member of the GDC bank just because any country has printed much more of its current currency or taken much more debt than its GDP does not mean that it will be eligible to get more GDCs. For example, if a company total value of 3 years GDP is US $1 trillion, but the total value of currencies that they have issued till now is more than $3 trillion in circulation, they will also get US $1 trillion only. The GDP of each country will be the intrinsic value on which it will get as much GDCs. That is, the GDP will be the new gold standard. So there will be a healthy race between nations to rapidly grow their real economies through real production. All countries' 5-year GDP calculations will have to be done by the GDC bank, whether they want to join it or not, immediately, so that the base currency conversion calculation rate is set. Whichever country joins later on, their cutoff base date will still remain as what was initially agreed upon date, and any currency that they have issued after the base date will be of no value for any calculation of conversion rate later on. 31st December 2018 or 31st March 2019 could be taken as the cutoff base date, so that no country, once it understands this system, can get more GDCs by cooking their as yet unaudited book of accounts. The United Nations, the World Bank and the IMF expertise and experience can be utilized to help in these efforts initially, but these bodies cannot be fully trusted to do an impartial work, as a few developed countries have more shareholding and veto powers in these institutions. GDC banks should utilize the technology behind digital currencies like crypto and blockchain, so that all transactions can be traced and there is no financial fraud. 4G or 5G, face recognition and voice authentication will enable cashless online transactions for everyone without a mobile phone in a few seconds. As of today, 5.2 billion people have smartphones, but by 2023, over 7.3 billion people will be possessing one. And if this GDC takes off fast, then the smartphone adoption acceleration will be even faster. Only kids below the age of 10 may be left without a smartphone by then, but their parents can do monetary transactions for them as is now. Even if 50 countries adopt the GDC to start with and start transactions in GDCs rather than the US dollars, I'm pretty sure that within 2 to 3 years, most of the other countries will soon follow. Only the top 10% countries like the USA, China, Eurozone, UK, Switzerland, etc. may resist initially or criticize, saying it is an impractical idea. But sooner or later, they will also have to toe the line once 90% of the world has switched to GDCs. The GDC bank can be formed within 2 years, and in another 3 years, the entire world can adopt it. Only countries that will suffer a downturn for a short time will be those who have printed money much more than their GDP figures, that is, countries living beyond their means. But over a long period of time, every country will benefit. It is a win-win situation, fair, transparent and unbiased system in which all the countries will benefit, and they can come out with sensible economic policies. The world moved from barter to gold to paper, and now it is time to move to a single universal digital currency. Just as air, water and internet flow seamlessly across borders, similarly GDC will enable faster and smoother trade between nations, making all nations wealthy and avoid colossal wastage of time. 4. The benefits. No printing, storing or transporting of currencies, so no cutting of trees nor burning fossil fuels, thereby reducing global warming dramatically. Just as Zimbabwe had to abandon its own recklessly printed currency in favor of the US dollar, the USA and all other countries who have recklessly printed their currencies will have to abandon it in favor of the meaningfully issued GDCs, so every country will get financially fit. All current currencies will have to be scrapped fully in favor of the GDC, so there will be no further high foreign exchange conversion cost to be given to banks when traveling from one country to another. Money will not get blocked for purchasing gold or silver as a hedge for fears of currency collapse, but will get routed into more productive purposes. No black money will be generated, so all governments will get more taxes, thereby tax rates will fall and greater happiness will be there globally. The life of printed notes is too short anyway, and coins are heavy to carry. No financial transaction costs. Money transfer globally can be done in seconds. No ATM required, and banks will need smaller branches, so their cost will get reduced and interest rates will plummet. No need of carrying wallets. No theft of money. No scope for hacking too. No currency counterfeit problems. No worries of currency appreciation or depreciation. We use fewer resources to run our lives and reduce pollution and save planets and animals. We make the world a much better place to live in than what we inherited. We are all living in an interdependent, interconnected era and have only one planet to live, and so become much more responsible and careful. Central banks will focus on issues other than currency devaluation to enable more exports, which is a zero-sum game anyway, as other countries follow suit. The price of gold, silver, Bitcoin, Euro, capital markets and real estate markets, dollar, etc. will rightly crash as they become worthless after central banks start lending more into MSMEs. GDC will ensure that every country will become financially prudent and focus on innovation and value addition to grow their GDPs. Countries will have to export more high-value goods and or services at a lower cost and reduce their consumptions. The inequalities in the world will reduce. The gap between the rich and the poor will reduce, leading to lesser poverty and more happiness. Every country will have to issue a unique ID to each citizen, just like the Indian government has issued Aadhaar, as well as open a free, no-frills savings account for anyone who still does not have it, and link these two to his mobile numbers to form a secure triad so that money can be instantly remitted online directly into their bank accounts. Even the poorest of the poor can then join the economy's mainstreams and contribute more, feeling valued. There will be no scope for any kickbacks in any government deals, as all transactions can be easily traced, leading to a cleaner government. Any government which does not want to opt for GDC and comes out with funny excuses for the same will clearly mean that they have skeletons to hide in their cupboards and do not want to get caught. So all people of such countries must put even more pressure to ensure that they get a government which is honest, non-corrupt and actually serves the people rather than the other way around. Inflation rates will reduce. Since everyone will have an online financial history and cannot escape to tax havens by doing scams, banks can give them instant bigger loans, so growth will be faster, leading to all-round development. The chances of loan defaults will reduce and running a bank will become less risky. 5. Humble request. 2020 should not go down in history as a year in which the future of humanity became bleak, but as a year in which a clear 2020 vision for a great new world order was adopted after thousands of years of messy financial transactions. Necessity is the mother of invention. It is a practical, implementable, revolutionary utopian idea. Politicians world over mostly think short-term of winning the next elections and typically push the can down the road, but now the road has finished. There is no time to debate or argue. Please support this petition by forwarding it to your country's president, prime ministers, finance ministers and the central bank governors, media houses, economists and key influencers globally. Many of their email IDs are attached here with. Forward this message to them and everyone you know of in all ways you can. That is by using WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, email, LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube, various media channels, websites, Google, calling up people, etc. so that all 8 billion people read or view it and support it and build a mass movement petition to their governments to opt for it fast, and they do not ignore, dilly-dally or dismiss it cynically. When 8 billion people speak together desiring a better future, then all countries' government will have no option but to listen to the wishes of their people. The world has suffered a lot with the third generation of currency format, that is the paper currencies, for so many years. And looking at the benefits of crypto and blockchain, some countries may launch their own virtual currencies. But then again, we will suffer for another 50 years with plethora of such virtual fiat currencies. And so it is high time that we learn from our bad experiences and skip this fourth semi-final stage and directly move to the fifth final stage of starting a single global digital currency. If you, yes you, the viewer, forward it to a minimum 100 people, and these 100 people in turn forward it to the next 100 people, then by the second level, 10,000 people would have seen it. When these 10,000 people forward it to the next 100 people, then 1 million people will get it. And when these 1 million people forward it to the next 100 people, then 100 million people would have seen it. And by the just the fifth forward, all 8 billion people on this planet would have read it. So be optimistic that your efforts of forwarding will get results, and forward it right now. Please translate it into languages for everyone to follow. No one is going to come to rescue you. You will have to take control of your and your children's destiny and must act now. Do not expect someone else to sort out the mess. You must do it your bit. Yes, there will be short-term disruptive pains, but we must be ready to sacrifice something for long-term gains. The time bomb is ticking very fast, and time for half-baked, half-hearted solutions is over, as we have reached a point of no return. Please forward, support, like, share. This is Pankaj Bhargav, founder and CEO of HRMatra.com, the world's most powerful HR and payroll software. Thank you for spending your time. Have a great future ahead.